All right, we are in Florence, Italy, on the famous Ponte Vecchio Bridge. Good day, YouTubers. Welcome to Florence, Italy. This city is so beautiful, it's no wonder it is one of the top-rated tourist destinations in all of Europe. This week, we're here in Florence, and we're visiting some friends of ours, Chris and Jenn, who are from California, but they're living in Florence for a couple of months, so they're trying to get a local flavor of the city. We want to share that local flavor with you, that way you can learn some of the tips and tricks of Florence. And we're going to show you some of the not so typical tourist spots. Now there's tons of videos out there that are going to show you all the museums and the piazzas, which are fantastic. But what I want to show you are maybe, I don't know if you'd call them off the beaten path. So let's get started and let's explore some of Florence, Italy. So we met up with Chris and Jen, our friends from California, who are now living in Florence. You guys are, how long are you living here?
3 months. Yeah.
You just decided to...
Decided we picked Florence, we love it, we love Italy. Florence in particular, with the proximity to Tuscany and just the ease of access to other major cities. But today we're gonna take you to a little small hidden gem up in the hills on the Altarno side, Pian di Giullari. It's about a 45 minute walk from Piazza Michelangelo. It's almost straight uphill, but absolutely worth the walk. And we'll end there with a fantastic little lunch for everybody with a great view.
What about this hike, Jen? Here's Jen, by the way.
Hello. We're hiking up Piazza Michelangelo, which is the best view of the city, and then we're going to take them beyond.
Here up into the hills, that's a beautiful town that borders Florence called Piazzola. It'll take you about an hour and a half from the Ponte Vecchio to get to the top of the square of Piazzola, but you're rewarded with a fantastic view from the other side and great little cafes to have your lunch. And you can take a public bus down.
So here you see, we're still up in Piazza Michelangelo, but you can get a little sense of the old remaining standing wall that used to engulf the city and protect them from their enemies. So they still keep that standing, and as you look further in the distance, it leads to the Pitti Palace, which is where the Medici family lived, and it's a beautiful palace, gardens around the palace called the Boboli Gardens. Definitely worth seeing.
What are we hearing right now, the bells?
The bells of the Duomo. Actually, I think that's the bells of Santa Croce, which is one of the three biggest churches in Florence. You have Santa Maria Novella, you have the Duomo, and you have Santa Croce.
This is the Santa Croce closest to, oh yeah, you can actually see the bells ringing right there.
Exactly.
Not sure if I can see it on camera, but.
Pretty cool.
That's cool.
We really like Michelangelo because you can come up here with a baguette, some cheese, some meats, and maybe a bottle of wine and sit on one of these benches. Now today, and most days like today, most spring and summer days are gonna be hot and muggy like it is. So there's a little beyond, there's a cafe at the edge where the stairs are leading up to Michelangelo. If you go a bit beyond them, not into the piazza, there's about six benches that are in the shade that not many people actually think about because they all head to the piazza. And you can sit in the shade and eat with the same view. I'd highly recommend it.
We continue our walk upward. The neighborhood we're going through now is called San Giorgio. We are approaching the neighborhood of Pian de Giullari, where we will have lunch at the Trattoria Omero. So right across from the restaurant is actually, I think, the birthplace of Galileo. That's pretty cool.
We actually get this amazing view as we turn this corner.
We make it back down the hill into Florence, or Firenze in Italian.
This is the church, Santa Croce. We heard the beautiful bells ringing this morning, and it's one of the three largest churches in Florence.
I know I mentioned earlier that I wanted to show you the non-touristy places, but you must visit the Duomo, where you can climb to the top. It's well worth it.
We're gonna work our way up to the top of the Duomo and look back over across the river to where we were earlier at Piazza Michelangelo. Give you a little perspective from the cathedral, and the detail we see up here is going to merge incredibly, incredibly detailed once we get up there at the top. It's pretty amazing as you get there.
Here we go.
Climb back down to the street level. And later we have dinner. Just finished dinner, now we're gonna do a little surprise for the ladies. We've got some champagne we're gonna take to the Piazza de Michelangelo, which overlooks the entire city. Now, I have a debate going with the ladies. I said, how can you taste a difference if you're drinking wine or champagne out of a styrofoam cup versus a glass. I think there is no difference whatsoever. It's gonna taste the exact same. They say, oh no, it tastes so much different in glass. No, that's baloney. It's gonna taste the exact same. Please comment below if you think it's different than champagne or wine in a glass versus some type of solo cup or styrofoam cup. I think it's all the same. Nonetheless, I think it's gonna be a very nice surprise, even though they're now downgrading my surprise to a low level because of my styrofoam cups. But still, look at this. Champagne. I took a bucket from the hotel with ice, and we're gonna take it to the top of the Piazza di Michelangelo.
I just wanna make sure you got a good look at what kind of cups we have for the champagne, the Prosecco. I hear that there's a difference.
Okay, what's the toast to?
Beautiful views
of Florence.
And a great day.
Light reaches for me, the future waits. Oh, it's calling my genesis. This is where.
Just being on the other side of the river, the Alto Arno, I believe it's a little more economical. The food's better. I think the vibe's a little more relaxed, a little less touristy. Cost-wise, the restaurants over there are certainly lower cost. And I think if you're into coffee, for sure, you'll find most coffee places in the morning over there maybe a euro 10 for an Americano. On this side, the Duomo side, you'll be paying 3 or 4 times as much. And if you frequent a restaurant several times in the same neighborhood, you'll almost always get a sconto, which means a discount. So they encourage those that live in the community to keep coming back.
YG.